Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to export HTML table as an Excel and C# using the Syncfusion Excel library. This library provides the support to export any number of HTML tables in a web page as an Excel worksheet. You'll see how to import the HTML table, then export that table into an Excel worksheet, and download the Excel document. First, I open an existing .NET Core application, where I added the Syncfusion.NET Core Excel library. If you like to know about getting started with the Syncfusion Excel library, check out the video link in the card above. Look at this HTML document with a table, which I am going to export as an Excel document using the Syncfusion Excel library. Before demonstrating the process of exporting an Excel document, I want to show you how it will be implemented in this application. The plan is to import the HTML table and generate the Excel document when this button is clicked. First, I add a new CSHTML file and name it Import HTML Table in the shared folder. Here, I will remove the existing code in the Import HTML Table file. I want to import the HTML table and generate the Excel document by clicking a button. So I defined a button component with the content import. I applied the style for the button. In addition to that, I included text content using HTML elements like paragraphs, lists, and labels. Okay, let me save the changes and run the application. As you can see, the import button is displayed. And when this button is clicked, I will generate an Excel document. Next, I'm going to add the HTML file that I want to export as an Excel file. So, right-click the webroot file and add the existing HTML file. Then, I go to the Home Controller class and add the action method import HTML table with a return type of action result. In this method, I perform different actions based on the value of the button parameter. First, I retrieve the base path of the webroot directory. The hosting environment object is used to access the hosting environment information, and the webroot path property returns the root path of the web server's static files, such as HTML, CSS, or JavaScript files. Next, I'm going to identify the button based on the value and implement the action. If the button is null, it returns a view. When you are clicking the import button, this else will be executed. I initialize the spreadsheet creation engine and Excel application object. Then, an iApplication object is obtained from the Excel engine, and its default version property is set to Excel 2016. Next, I create a new workbook in the Excel application with a specified number of worksheets. In this case, 1 indicates that we want to create a workbook with 1 worksheet. I access the first worksheet in the workbook. The worksheets property of the workbook returns a collection of all the worksheets in the workbook using the indexer. I'm going to create a file stream to read the contents of the import HTML table file located in the specified basepath directory. The basepath of the webroot directory, already obtained from the hosting environment.webrootpath property. It concatenates the basepath with the relative path to the import HTML table file. File mode is open and the stream will have read access. Let's see how to import an HTML table into the specified worksheet. The import HTML table method is called on the worksheet object, which represents a worksheet in the Excel workbook. It takes 3 parameters. File, this is the memory stream object that contains the HTML table data. The import HTML table method reads the HTML table from this memory stream and imports it into the worksheet. 1, 1, this parameter specifies the starting row and column index in the worksheet where the HTML table will be imported. In this case, 1, 1 indicates that the table will be imported starting from the first row and first column. Next, I will show you how to automatically adjust the column widths and row heights in the worksheet based on their content. Used range property returns a range object that represents the used range in the worksheet. The used range includes all the cells that have data or formatting applied to them. Autofit columns is a method that calls on the used range of the worksheet. It automatically adjusts the width of each column within the used range to fit the content of the cells in that column. This ensures that the content is visible without any truncation or excess whitespace. Autofit rows is another method that calls on the used range of the worksheet. It automatically adjusts the height of each row within the used range to fit the content of the cells in that row. This ensures that the content is fully visible without any cutoff or hidden text. Next, I save the workbook into the memory stream and reset its position to top of form. The workbook.saveAs method saves the workbook object into the memory stream. And it sets the position of the memory stream back to the beginning. Finally, I download the saved Excel document using the file method. This method returns the memory stream as a file with the specified MIME type and file name. The browser or client receiving the response will recognize the MIME type and treat it as a downloadable Excel file with the provided file name. You will see the import button on the output page. And the Excel document is downloaded when I click the import button. I open the downloaded document and you see the HTML table worksheet. In this video, I have shown you how to import the HTML table from the application and export the imported table to Excel using the Syncfusion Excel library. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our file format products through our community license. If you found this video useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching this video.